Open Heavens on the Go, Monday, July 13th, 2020. Topic, The Virtuous Woman. Memory verse, Proverbs 31:11. The heart of her husband doth safely trust in her, so that he shall have no need of spoil. Proverbs 31:11. Bible reading, Proverbs 31:10-31. Who can find a virtuous woman? For her price is far above rubies. The heart of her husband doth safely trust in her, so that he shall have no need of spoil. She will do him good and not evil all the days of her life. She seeketh wool and flax and worketh willingly with her hands. She is like the merchant's ships. She bringeth her food from afar. She riseth also while it is yet night, and giveth meat to her household, and a portion to her maidens. She considereth a field, and buyeth it. With the fruit of her hands, she planteth a vineyard. She girded her loins with strength, and strengtheneth her arms. She perceiveth that her merchandise is good. Her candle goeth not out by night. She layeth her hands to the spindle, and her hands hold the distaff. She stretcheth out her hand to the poor, yea, she reacheth forth her hands to the needy. She is not afraid of the snow for her household, for all her household are clothed with scarlet. She maketh herself coverings of tapestry. Her clothing is silk and purple. Her husband is known in the gates when he sitteth among the elders of the land. She maketh fine linen and selleth it, and delivereth girdles unto the merchant. Strength and honor are her clothing, and she shall rejoice in time to come. She openeth her mouth with wisdom, and in her tongue is the law of kindness. She looketh well to the ways of her household, and eateth not the bread of idleness. Her husband arise up and call her blessed, her husband also, and he praiseth her. Many daughters have done virtuously, but thou excellest them all. Favor is deceitful, and beauty is vain, but a woman that feareth the Lord, she shall be praised. Give her of the fruit of her hands, and let her own works praise her in the gates. The message. Today is my wife's birthday, and there are so many lessons that women, especially young brides, can learn from her. She is a powerful woman, I know that. She has many people who take instructions from her, but as powerful as she is, and even though she has seen me in my weakest moments, I have no doubt that I am her head. It does not matter what is on her itinerary. If I say I would like you to go with me to so and so place, the best she can do is try to convince me otherwise. If I insist, she would cancel whatever she was to do and come along with me. The Bible in Ephesians 5:23 says, "For the husband is the head of the wife, even as Christ is the head of the church." The husband is the head of the wife. No matter how educated or successful you are, your husband is your head, and you must regard him as such at all times. It is a terrible thing for a husband to feel his wife is his head. Many men are misbehaving in their marriages simply because they want to establish that they are the head of their wives. Also, my wife is my number one fan. She wrote in the book Mathematics of Marriage, which we co-authored, that as my helpmate, she knows she cannot help me without my instructions. So, when they come, her response is, "Yes, sir." Busy as she is, she still cooks my meals and serves me herself. Many young ladies these days leave everything to the house help. My wife still trims my nails for me. There was a time when I was a teacher and was staying far from town. She had to cut my hair during that period. She is the only partner of the Adeboye Corporation. She doesn't delegate her primary duties to anyone else. Just like the virtuous woman described in Proverbs 31:1-31, I safely rest on my wife. Anything I uphold, she upholds too. Can your husband rely on you? Make up for your husband's weaknesses. Celebrate his successes. Be his number one cheerleader. I wish my lovely wife a happy birthday. Key point. Wife, your husband is your head. If you take care of the head, the body will be fine. Bible reading in 1 year. Micah 1-7. Hymn for today. God give us Christian homes. The Open Heavens is written by Pastor E.A. Adeboye, the General Overseer of the Redeemed Christian Church of God. God bless you.